New this morning, getting kids excited about reading can sometimes be a challenge. Get them hooked, and it can lead to a lifetime of learning and academic achievement. So more and more schools are using technology now to motivate kids, including the latest in high-tech gadgets.
So let's begin reading.
Fifth graders in Ms. Meyer's classroom at Fitz Elementary School are busy reading Bridge to Terabithia.
Jess slid out of bed and into his overalls.
It's a typical activity for elementary students, but take a closer look here, and you can see something a little different and cutting edge.
He began to trot across the yard.
Many of the students are reading from traditional books, but others are using something sleeker, iPod touches, and even the hottest tech gadget around, the Apple iPad.
Anything technology, they just love.
These students are trying out different ways to read a book. The Conestoga Valley School District is putting various devices in kids' hands, hoping it makes reading cool.
This is the generation of computers and gamers, and this is enticing to these kids, and we have to keep them interested and excited.
This may be the future of school books. Instead of buying traditional books and textbooks by the dozen, any book can simply be downloaded.
The cost of purchasing books is very high in school districts, not to mention of storing them, of upkeep, of renewing them, purchasing new versions. So having all of those in one electronic format accessible really anytime, anywhere, is the way to go.
What is she feeling?
In Ms. Meyer's class, students rotate the devices, and they seem to be a hit.
I'd rather pick up this than picking up a regular book because this is more motivating.
Well, there are certainly things you can do with the iPad you can't do with a typical textbook. For instance, you can take notes right here on the page. Try doing that with a typical textbook. Also, it's very easy to look up a word that maybe you don't know. Just go right to dictionary.com and type in any word you want.
His hot skin crawled.
But this isn't just about nifty gadgets.
Remember, you're not reading just to read. You're trying to look for things.
It's about educating a generation of kids on their level.
I think exposing them to it and teaching them how to use it properly is my job. And whether or not they decide to use a regular book or an e-reader, that's their choice.
And many kids seem to have already made their choice.
It's really fun and it's more exciting to read it than just staring at a book.
And we should mention, along with the iPod touches there and the iPad, they also are using the Kindle, the e-reader,
yes,
as well.
Yes, I
and
saw that.
That's right. So they're using some other stuff. And then what they're doing is they're getting feedback from the kids on all of those devices. Mm-hmm. What do they like about them? What don't they like about them? And then trying to make a decision as you go forward, which really are the best devices. And so far, as you might expect, the iPad's the most popular. It's a good size.
Oh, yeah. I mean, so. There is something you said about physically having a book and leafing through pages, but
right.
The iPad, think about the backpacks. And, you know, all the kids deal with the heavy
exactly.
backpacks. That could
it's
alleviate
terrific.
Some of those problems
yeah.
in future years.
And real quick, I should mention, we showed they're going to dictionary.com, but on some of the programs, you can just literally just highlight a word, and without even going to another program, it'll come up with a definition for you.
Our kids are going to be so far ahead of us. You know what I mean?
They already are, Lori.
I know. But you were pretty good at that iPad. You enjoyed
it
didn't
great.
You?
That's a nice device.